the moment in time when you guys all ran out to midfield together knowing that you were the champs?
That was just sort of an amazing feeling. I think we knew about 30 seconds, when there were 30 seconds left of the game and we were three goals ahead, that we knew that we could really keep them out for that last bit. And if we could, you know, continue playing how we were playing, we had the championship. And that was an amazing feeling. It was like a high.
It was amazing. Honestly, when we ran out there, I just wanted to thank our fans and our parents and everybody for coming and supporting us. And it means a lot to us. And we worked so hard this season and are so excited to end like this.
That's what your coach was telling us earlier, that you guys as a unit came together early with a lot of leadership, nine seniors or whatever, and didn't have a lot of the peaks and valleys that a lot of teams do because of that. Did you see that as the season went on?
Yeah, I think definitely we had a very strong season, especially because we're sort of working in like a two-year program. We only had two players different from the previous year, and that was really helpful in still sort of maintaining this core and this awesome sort of like central. And there was leadership from all different levels, whether it was the seniors, whether it was, you know, just the younger players, it was all over the place. It really felt like we were connected like a unit.
Yeah. And we are also very, we had a lot of depth. When Sarah was sick or Rachel was sick, we all
stepped up.
And really helped each other through the hard times. And it just shows that how great we, and as a team, we were.
Now, what did you guys do during the rain delay?
Yeah.
We went into a locker room, and it was sort of not a tight space at all, but a very eventually changing space. It was very different from this open, nice area. And we talked for a little while. We were talking with Robin, our coach, and then we sort of just sat in a circle and talked as a team, you know, what we were seeing, what we wanted to improve, you know.
Because that lasted about 15 minutes.
Yeah, exactly.
The other hour and a half. About,
yeah. Was there ever a quiet time where you just ran out something to say? It's like, okay.
We just need to keep our legs moving.
Some people put music in. Yeah. They were just sort of like trying to stay focused. I thought, given the weird circumstances, I thought we came out really fired up and ready.
You came out great.
Yeah.
Talk about last year's loss and how it fueled your.
It's a pleasure to meet you. Sorry, Derek.
No problem. Fueled your fire this year. Just talk about losing last year and how it motivated you guys for this spring.
Losing last year was really hard. But we also lost Jenna James. Mm-hmm. We weren't sure how the season was going to go, but we knew we had to complete the cycle that we started, and that it was like a 2-year run. Mm-hmm. And we just needed to come out here and do it.
I think we also have a special sort of, I wouldn't say it's a rivalry, but it's definitely some sort of tension with friends. Like, and we're great competitors. I love playing friends because it's always guaranteed to be a good game. We played them our freshman year in the championships, and that was really also an intense game. And we've had a history with them, and they're really a great team to play.
So I'm going to slide Sarah in. Sarah, why don't you slide on in here? Just talk about the win and what you guys accomplished here this afternoon. It's like it took like 40 hours to play this game.
I think we weren't playing as well as we usually do before the delay. Mm-hmm. And then delay, I think it actually gave us an advantage in that we could visualize what we wanted to do, and we talked about what we needed to work on, mm-hmm. and also what we were doing well, and we came out and really succeeded. And we impressed ourselves.
Mm-hmm. Talk about the 2-year plan.
it's an interesting idea, but like, last year, like they mentioned, we had a really strong attacker who left, and I think also last year we depended on her for most of our goals, and this year we just came together as a team. We already had we had experience last year together, and we learned how to work with each other, and we only got better as the season progressed.
Right.
And we, like Ian said before, we were peaking at the right time.
Okay. What does this mean? Championship means to you?
It means everything. I haven't won a championship here at Park. I'm a junior. I've been to two other ones, soccer and last year's lacrosse. Oh, no, and another soccer, three. And to finally win, it's like, I'm speechless. It's a great feeling.
Right. What does it mean to you?
It just means the world to me. Being a champion, I love the feeling. I love the drive, and to win championships is the reason why I like play lacrosse. So.
and take us home. What does this mean to you?
I couldn't imagine ending a season in any other way. This was the perfect overall completion, not just to my career, but especially to this season, which was a really special one. And like Sarah said and Ian said, it's just an amazing feeling. And I'm sad, but so glad this is the way to go out.
All right, completion, as they say, completion. One more time, introduce yourself.
I'm Rebecca Kolodner.
I'm Ian Baker.
I'm Sarah Lessons.
And these are three members of the 2013 IAM B Conference champion, the Park Bruins. Win it this afternoon. It took forever, but in the end, it's Park 15 and Friends 11. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Toney.